Want to learn about Windows auto-tuning and whether you should disable it or not? Here is a complete guide for you. This is the Windows Club. Windows auto-tuning feature is said to improve the performance for programs that receive TCP data over a network. It is nothing new. It was introduced in Windows Vista and is present in Windows 11 too. In today's internet, the range of latencies and throughput speeds is just too large to manage statically. It needs to be adjusted dynamically. Windows will dynamically adjust the receive buffer size to the throughput and latency of the link using this feature. Programs like automatic updates, Windows Update, Remote Desktop Connection, Windows Explorer for Network File Copy, etc. use WinHTTP or Windows HTTP services. Window auto-tuning feature is enabled by default in Windows and makes data transfers over networks more efficient. But if your network uses an old router or your firewall software does not support this feature, then you may experience slow data transfers or even loss of connectivity. According to Microsoft, when the receive window auto-tuning feature is enabled for HTTP traffic, older routers, older firewalls, and older operating systems that are incompatible with the receive window auto-tuning feature may sometimes cause slow data transfer or a loss of connectivity. When this occurs, users may experience slow performance. To check the status of auto-tuning feature on your system, type cmd in the search bar and run command prompt as an administrator. Type the following command and hit enter after each one. Netsh interface TCP show global. If you see normal written against receive window auto-tuning level, it means that the feature is enabled and it is working fine. To disable Windows auto-tuning, run the following command. Netsh int tcp set global auto-tuning level is equal to disabled. To enable Windows auto-tuning, run the following command. Netsh int tcp set global auto-tuning level is equal to normal. Let the default settings of Windows auto-tuning feature be enabled. If your network uses an older router or your firewall software does not support this feature and you are experiencing poor or no connectivity issues, only then may you disable this feature and see if it works in your favor. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.